Hey guys, it's Erica. If you follow my blog or follow me on Facebook, then you've probably seen this week that I have a new makeup vanity. And I've had a lot of questions about some different items, and I thought I would share some of the information about that with you. This is my second or third time trying to film this video. If you see this little booger right over here, that's my Canon EOS T3i. That thing is of the devil. I cannot get it to record, cannot get it to focus. So anyways, I'm using this El Cheapo little Canon camera. Hope that it does okay. So, it's really warm here in Kentucky, and my allergies are terrible. I'm kind of wheezy today, and I have a sore throat, but I will do the best I can. Just bear with me. I'm going to start over here. When you first walk into this room, this is where I keep my nail polish racks. I have two of those, and I got them from Amazon. Up here, this is a shelf that I got from Lowe's. You actually just attach the brackets to the wall. The shelf lays on top, and you have a lot of versatility. There's a lot of different sizes of boards that you can get. That is wonderful. This is the Vanity Girl Hollywood mirror. A lot of people ask questions about that. There's a knob down here on the corner where you can brighten or dim those lights. I'll show you that in a minute. This is the mom dressing table from IKEA. This is the Tobias clear acrylic chair, which is just beautiful. I love this, and it's the perfect height this way for your vanity. It worked out just perfectly. And this is the Alex 9 drawer chest that I also got. What I will probably do is start at the top and work my way down. So if you are ready, we will start up here. This is just a headband for when I'm doing my makeup to get my hair out of my face. A couple of these containers, the ones that have this print, I got those at the dollar store. Very cute and very handy. In this one, I have a newer style MAC blush palette, an older style eyeshadow palette from MAC, Stila Pro Artist palette, a NARS blush palette, the Tarte, this was a limited edition 2013 blush palette, Stila in the Light, the new Tarte Magnificent, which is beautiful. One of my favorites, the Too Faced Boudoir Eyes. And I have two of the Too Faced Romantic Eye palettes. These banks actually came from, I think, the dollar store too. One is a lipstick and one is a high heel. These are the limited edition Disney Villain palettes from e.l.f. Here's another one of those cases. And these were like $3 or $4 a piece. It holds my Coastal Scents 88 palette, the Balm Nude Tude palette, Naked 1, Naked 2, and Naked 3 palettes, the Lorac Pro. Let's see, here's a MAC Hello Kitty, a couple of Stila, Rockin' in Rio, and I don't know what that is. Mally, I think that's called Central Park, the Sleek All Naturel eyeshadow palette, and then an e.l.f. eyeshadow palette. This wire rack came from Walmart, and it's just one of those like desk organizer things. And it holds a large Tarte eyeshadow palette. That was called either the Art of Giving or Gift of Giving, whatever. It came out right around Christmas time. I have a large C palette, a Coastal Scents 10 blush palette, and the Coastal Scents Reveal palette. Behind that, I have a couple of my acrylic lipstick holders with some lipsticks that I don't wear as much as the ones that are down here on my vanity. So, moving over here, I guess I could show you this mirror. I'm going to try to stay out of it because I don't have on any makeup today. But down here, there's a little knob. And I'm going to try not to blind you. Woo! As you can see, they get pretty light, and you can also dim it. So, love the mirror. It is wonderful. Popper! Look who's here to help me! That's Popper Dog! Okay, as far as what's on my vanity, I got these little lipstick containers from Amazon. Each one of them holds like, what, 24 lipsticks. This one is all MAC. This one is mainly Rimmel and Revlon, a couple of Christian Dior, L'Oreal, and Wet n Wild. This one is, let's see, NARS, YSL, a couple of Too Faced, Stila, YSL, Bobbi Brown, Urban Decay, Laura Geller, CoverGirl, a couple of Estee Lauder, Wet n Wild, Estee Lauder, OCC Lip Tars, this is Heidi Klum, It Cosmetics, and Maybelline. Back here I keep a little container with just some Q-tips and cotton rounds. Got a little Bath & Body Works lotion and some allergy eye drops because my allergies are terrible. Most of my makeup brushes are MAC or Sigma, and this is actually a tool caddy from Pampered Chef. It works great to hold your brushes. And I have a little hand sanitizer that hangs here. It's in Marshmallow. Pepper! These clear drawers are by Muji, and I really love the acrylic accents in here. That's my chair, my nail polish racks, and these, and my lipstick holders. So I'll real quick go through kind of what I keep in these. I keep a lot of frequently used products in my Muji drawers. In the top one, it's mainly frequently used eyeliners and lip liners. I have a lot of Physicians Formula, Revlon, L'Oreal, a lot of NYX, a lot of Urban Decay. These are wonderful. Yeah, Rimmel, Jordana, Rimmel, Urban Decay, Urban Decay, Three Custom Color, Stila, Urban Decay. The second drawer are mascaras that I'm currently using. Stila, Wet n Wild, Bombshell, which I'm not a big fan of. Ico, Black Magic, this is by far their best one. Benefit, The Real, Laura Mercier, Tarte, Lights, Camera, Lashes, Voluminous, Carbon Black, Dior Show, Lancome, Hypno Star, Clump Crusher, Bag Gout, and NARS. In this next drawer down, this is where I keep things to brighten my under eye. I have my Dream Lumi concealer, my MAC Prep and Prime highlighter in Radiant Rose. This is wonderful. Maybelline Instant Age Rewind in the brightening color. This is Bare Minerals Well Rested, an Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder in Diffused Light. This is my Sephora my Z Palette by Sephora. In here I keep just a couple of shadows. This is Shroom by MAC, and that is a great brow bone highlight. This is Shimma Shimma by Makeup Geek. That's a great inner corner highlight. And then this is a MAC Sculpting Powder in Emphasize, and that is great to set your Prep and Prime highlighter. In the next drawer, I have some eyeshadow primers that I use. NARS, Laura Mercier, Urban Decay Primer Potion, Lorac, Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk, e.l.f., Too Faced, Palladio Herbal Eyeshadow Primer, Too Faced Shadow Insurance, and then this little pack of primers came with my Naked 3 palette. And in the bottom of this 5 drawer Muji container, I have just some balm stains, like this Lip Surgeons, Tarte Lip Surgeons, an Elizabeth Arden lip gloss, a Gucci perfume, and this little essential oil thing. It came from either Ipsy or Birchbox. In the 2 drawer, it's kind of deeper, Muji drawers. In the first one, I have some concealers. I have a MAC Paint Pot, a couple of CoverGirl Olay, MAC Studio Finish, MAC Pro Longwear, Sonia Kashuk, Benefit Erase Paste, Eve Pearl, Revlon, Benefit, Maybelline, The Body Shop, Maybelline, Garnier, love this, The Body Shop, Neutrogena, Rimmel, Physicians Formula. And then in the bottom drawer, I have some foundation primers that I use. The Maybelline Baby Skin, Smashbox, Photo Finish, the original Hard Candy, Sheer Envy, the new one, which will be great for this year because having aluminized skin is one of the trends for spring 2014, and this is the new Skin Illuminating Primer. My favorite foundation primer is probably just the Tarte Clean Slate. It's really great. I have the original and the original Fix and Perfect, and then the Fix and Perfect Pro by Rimmel, some NYX, Bare Minerals, Professional, and that go. Guys, I know I'm going fast, but this video was like 45 minutes the first time I did it, so I'm really trying to go fast. In this mom table, it has one drawer, and when you open it up, as you can see, it goes the full length of the table. I categorized it by brand and types of products. These little containers are Sterlite. I ordered them from Amazon. This is just a mirror to look close up while I'm doing my eye makeup. I'll start over here. I have a lot of my NARS products. As you can see, I've got a lot, my multiples. NARS is by far my favorite high-end product brand. I have just an EOS hand lotion. This is the Berry one. I love their hand lotions. A couple of palettes that I use quite frequently, Benefit and Too Faced. And this is just a disposable baking dish. It's like aluminum, but it's really good because you can mold it to the size that you need to keep everything tight and from shuffling around. I have some makeup setting sprays, NYX, Urban Decay All Nighter, D-Slick, Fix Plus, and then another trend for spring 2014 is orange lips. And here are some of my favorites that will be in an upcoming blog post. I have my Milani Mineral blushes. Those you can no longer get. Some of my favorite NYX compacts that I use quite frequently. I also tossed a couple of Tarte Amazonian Clay blushes in here that I use a lot. This is Memorable and Exposed. In this long skinny one, I have some Revlon lip butters and some Maybelline Color Whispers. This container back here is all e.l.f. Blush and bronzer duos and single blushes. In this one right here, I have some of my favorite brow products. Maybelline Brow Powder, the e.l.f. Duos for your brows, the Maybelline Definer Brow Pencils, and some Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. In this long skinny one, I have just a hair pick, and then a couple of lip products, a Balm Stain by Wet n Wild. This is in Nudist Colony. This is the best one if you ask me. And then a Rimmel Stay Glossy Gloss in Endless Summer. Then I have a couple of lipsticks that wouldn't fit in my lipstick holders. So one is NYX, and the other one is Laura Mercier. Back here I have several of my NYX blushes. I have lots of those and love them. If you can't tell, there's like a theme going on here. Yet another NYX container. And this is all NYX lipsticks. I have the basic round lipsticks, the matte, and the butter lipsticks. And I also have a couple of the butter lip balms in Marshmallow and Ladyfinger. In this little basket over here, I put stuff that I tend to use daily. There's also a little Lady Gaga perfume sample. I don't use that daily. It's just sitting in here. But I have my Neutrogena foundation, my e.l.f. Kabuki brush, a couple of clean spoolies that I washed from some mascara, my MAC MSF in Soft and Gentle, a beauty blender. This Bare Minerals container is actually my Ben Nye banana powder, but you really need a sifter for that, so I just use this container. Wet n Wild Brulee, CoverGirl True Plum Blush, the Balm Instain Blush in Toile, Wet n Wild Reserve Your Cabana, and then a couple of gel eyeliners, Maybelline and L'Oreal. So now we will go through the Alex 9 drawers. I'll try to make this quick. In the top one, these clear containers, I think I got those at Walmart a long time ago. And let's see, I have all of the Wet n Wild trios here. I have all of the 6-pan palettes by Wet n Wild. And then I only have one of the new 5-pan palettes. This is the only one I've seen that I wanted, and it's the Naked Truth. This is a Ferrero Rocher candy lid. Candy came in it. And I have just some blushes in that. I have an e.l.f. cream blush. I had a couple more of those, but my mom likes to shop my stash whenever she's here. But that's okay. Love you, Mom. I have some Dream Bouncy blushes, a Sleek blush palette, a Tarte stain, and also a cheek stain from The Balm. In this one, I have a L'Oreal blush, the Wet n Wild blushes, an e.l.f. blush, and all of the Balm blushes. These are CoverGirl Cheekers, Estela, Convertible Color, Jane. What is this? Amazing Cosmetics. E.l.f., a Dream Mousse blush. These are all Jordana. Two, Sonia Kashuk. And then this little disposable baking dish has cream blushes by Maybelline and NYC. In the second drawer, this is also one of those container things from the dollar store. This clear plastic one again is Walmart. The circle ones I got from the dollar store. So in here I have just some box blushes, two Fox in the Box by Hard Candy, Benefit Dandelion, some sharpeners of different sizes. These are NYX butter glosses and lip creams, some Mega Shine lip glosses, the Hard Candy bronzers. Tiki is actually a highlighter, but it's all the Hard Candy bronzers and a couple of blushes, some oil blotting sheets. Back here I have some highlighters, the Hard Candy, I have three of those back there, the Benefit Gilded, e.l.f., the Balm Mary Luminizer, Benefit What's Up and High Beam, MAC Cream Color Base. Over here I have a new Wet n Wild Reserve Your Cabana, Clinique, a couple of NYC limited edition ones, e.l.f., Lorac Perfectly Lit Spotlight Powder, and Kevin Aucoin Celestial Powder. In this next one, this is a clear organizer from Walmart. If you can see, there's like little sections to it back here, and it's mainly drugstore. So back here I have all e.l.f. These are the Geometric palettes, and then the quads, some CoverGirl quads, trios, and singles, Revlon, a couple of Wet n Wild palettes and Physicians Formula, Too Faced, Avon, Estee Lauder, Estee Lauder, Rimmel, 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 Physicians Formula, and L'Oreal. Back here I have some Maybelline quads and this little guy and a duo. Here's where I keep all of these eye studios, and then there's also a couple of Sigma colors. In this little tray, again from the dollar store, I have your old school Merle Norman pencils because everybody used to wear these back in the day. I have some chapsticks and some Dew Kiss from Avon and a couple of things of Carmex. This little container has some cream eyeshadows from Clinique and also from Victoria's Secret. If you follow my blog, you've probably seen that I accidentally threw away two whole ice trays full of NYX single shadows. This is all I have left, but that's okay. In this side, I have some L'Oreal Infallible shadows, some Maybelline Color Tattoos, Jordana, Palladio, and some Wet n Wild singles. Over here, I have some Coastal Scents, MAC, the Marilyn Monroe edition, e.l.f., Hard Candy, Milani, Almay. This cream shadow came in an Ipsy bag. I don't know what the brand is, but it has this little martini on it. And then Clinique, Avon, e.l.f., and what is this? NYC, and also a Mally eyeshadow stick. Then in the next drawer down, this sturdy container came from Walmart. Back here I have some of these Victoria's Secret eyeshadows. I don't wear them much anymore, but I didn't really want to get rid of them just yet. This is all Physicians Formula, and let's see, there's the shimmer strips, color correcting powder, beads or whatever, highlighters, and blushes. Physicians Formula is such a great brand. This is all my Flower Cosmetics, like eyeshadow quads and blush and bronzer duos. I have the Giella I Am Glam, Kim Kardashian's makeup dude was the first one to really get that popular. This is MAC Silver Dusk, and if you brush this on top of that cream color base, it's like put your eyes out disco ball highlight, and I love it. Piper! She gets so upset with a camera. She hates me to film. So that's one reason why I don't do YouTube anymore. It really upsets my dog. So in this little container, I have some replacement pads for my e.l.f. eyelash curler. And then these down in here are for my Shuimura eyelash curler. I don't wear fake eyelashes, but every girl needs a couple pairs in her stash. So I have a couple pairs of MAC. I got this in an Ipsy glam bag. There's some Ardell lashes back in here. Some Revlon Precision eyelash glue and Duo lash adhesive. In this drawer down here, again, this container is one of those from the dollar store. I have my 8-pan palettes from Wet n Wild. These are just some bronzers that I use more often. Too Faced, Chocolate Soleil, Sonia Kashuk, Cream Bronzer, and Benefit Hoola. Back here is an It Cosmetics Vitality Disc. Ticket to Brazil by Wet n Wild. CoverGirl, a NARS duo that's in Laguna and Orgasm. e.l.f. Golden Bronzer. Bourjois. This is the like chocolate bar bronzer. Revlon, which I think is now discontinued. Ah, horror. A sleek contour palette. And this one is just a blush and bronzer. But in my travel bag, I keep the one that also has the highlighter in it. So here we have an NYC, a Rimmel matte bronzer, a Laura Geller, two NYC Sunny bronzers, and two Bon Bell or Bonnie Bell, however you want to say it. I have the Wet n Wild Princess and Goddess bronzers and also this limited edition, Everything Under the Sun. That was such a good one. This is the double-ended bronzer and highlight stick from M Cosmetics. It's Michelle Fons makeup. I think it's pronounced Chiaroscuro. A L'Oreal True Match concealer that I actually use as a bronzer. And then, let's see, Ada Cosmetics. This is actually a really good bronzer too. I think it came in my Birchbox. Piper. In this one, I have some mineral makeup. If you know me at all, you know I don't like mineral makeup, but I do have a lot of it, and I didn't really want to get rid of it just yet. So I have Bare Minerals, Everyday Minerals, and Color Science. And this is just an Everyday Minerals brush that came with that set. I have three Coty Airspun powders in different shades. A Laura Geller Balance and Brighten, and Studio Fix by MAC. This is a big tub of the Ben Nye Banana Powder. This is the Fresh Sugar Lip Birthday Perk from Sephora. A Wet n Wild Lip Balm. In these disposable baking dishes, I think those came from Walmart, I have some EOS lip balms. My favorites are the Lemon, Strawberry, and Blueberry. Then I also have a Vaseline Lip Therapy. This is more drugstore lip glosses. Bonbel, Milani, Revlon, some Nivea lip butters, that kind of thing. These are more high-end. I have a lot of NARS, Pop Beauty, Philosophy, Bare Minerals, Sephora, Stila. You get the idea. In this container back here, I have some new mascaras that I've not used yet. The new Physician's Formula Organic Wear CC Curl Care Mascara. A new Clump Crusher CoverGirl Lash Perfection. So my camera auto shut off, but I have the Physician's Formula Clump Crusher, Rocket Volume, Lash Perfection, a double-ended Maybelline, and then a Bad Gal lash. In this little pink container, again, this came from the dollar store, I have some tube lip glosses. These are Victoria's Secret and The Body Shop, Estee Lauder, Lancome, and Clinique. I have a Revlon powder, two translucent e.l.f. powders, Rimmel Stay Matte Milani, a Dream Matte powder, and then Palladio Rice powder. I bought this little poof somewhere online. I don't remember where. I think this one's NYX and this one is NYX. My baby lips. And then these are just some tinted lip balms, lip sliders by NYC. I have two e.l.f. high def powders. This one is translucent. This one is in yellow. And then I have a couple of these makeup lock and seal. And you, I really don't remember ordering that, but supposedly you put some in this little cap, smoosh your eyeshadow brush down in it, and use it to like apply pigments so you won't have a lot of fallout. We'll try it. And then last but not least, this little back drawer is kind of a free-for-all. It's got some compacts in it, some concealers I've not used, weird products like these fibers that you brush on your lashes to make them fuller, just different things like that. This is all BB and CC creams, tinted moisturizers, like Sonia Kashuk, Aveeno, Laura Mercier, Smashbox, Pure Minerals. I also have the Revlon Whipped, Colorstay Whipped foundation, and a Benefit, some kind of gorgeous foundation. Here are my sugar lip products. These two are Plum, that one's Rose. A Coors Lip Butter and Pomegranate. I love the CoverGirl 3-in-1 foundations. As you can see, there's four of them in here. These foundations actually go all the way back up in there. Estee Lauder, love this. Maybelline, I think it's Maybelline, yeah. Superstay, the 3-in-1 Rimmel, Dream Lumi, MAC, Photo Ready, and Colorstay, the DNA. They actually go all the way back up in there. All right, guys, I think that just about does it. Say bye, Piper. I know I talked like 90 miles a minute, but it's impossible to get all that done in one video and get it uploaded to YouTube. So if you have any questions, if I left anything out, don't hesitate to ask or leave me a comment below. Message me on my blog or on Facebook, and I'll be happy to get back to you. And thanks again for stopping by and for continuing to support me and my blog. And until next time, bye.